So you would like to have a Discord server for you to hang out with your friends, maybe watch some movies, play some games from time to time. But YouTube is filled with tutorials on how to make servers for huge communities and how to grow them. Well, today we'll be making a cozy Discord server to hang out with friends. My name is Gael Level, make sure you subscribe and let's begin. So the first thing you want to do is go to the bottom of your server list and click Add a Server. Right there. Now you'll be prompted to create your own or start from a template, but if you really wanted to make it yours, I suggest you create your own. That being said, the server we'll create today, there will be a link in the description for you to just use it as a template. Here we're gonna click one for me and my friends, and we'll give it a name. Now me personally, I like giving it names of location types, things like the theater, the manor, the arena, the mansion. We'll call this one the loft. We'll also upload an icon. The picture could be anything, it's a private server after all, but I always suggest people to go with a face because it will be more recognizable at a glance, especially if there's high contrast on that picture. So I'm gonna pull out my meme folder and we'll go with this one. Yeah, you're not missing this one in the list. All right, congrats, you actually created your server. Now we're gonna go and take a look at the categories first before we start putting text or voice channels. I'll show you an example of a private server where here you have the welcome category. If someone just joined, they can read the rules to understand more what the server is about and also the announcements if there's anything new going on. In that example server, I have an event hub that I keep up top because I want everyone to immediately see what's going on if there's an event. So I'll have a text channel and a voice channel for the event. And then I'll have the lobby where people can chat. They can talk about games and have a bot post like free games and stuff if they wanna post memes. Then we have some of the stuff that we just tend to talk about more in that server, like movies, TV, horror related content. And in here we have a pics and vids channel. And this one is for people to just share whatever's going on with their day. So in our brand new server, we're gonna start by editing this category that was there by default. And we're gonna call it welcome. You wanna make sure you save changes. Boom, and there it is. I'm gonna edit the one that says voice channel. We'll call this one lobby. Don't worry about the whole decoration part, we'll do that later. And save changes. Now we're gonna create a new category, and this one is going to be specifically for bots. You just right click where it's empty and click create category. And again, private server, give it a fun name. You can make this a private category if you don't want your users to see the channels that are in there. Now, in my example server, I have a special category for creators because I have a lot of content creators in that server. So here they can talk about content creation, they can post about DIY, tech related stuff. They can post their own resources, tutorials, anything informative. And in here, live and video will post when they go live or they post a video on their platforms. And your content, then your content is if they want to share some extra content with us. So in our new server, I'm not gonna put that because I don't know what your friends are up to. But if you do have an extra activity that you know a lot of people are gonna do, you would want that. If it's a specific game where you want some information, some updates and things like that, you can also create a category just for that. All right, so now we'll create the category for the voice channels. We'll call it lounge. Now let's go ahead and populate those categories with some channels. I'm gonna edit this default one. This will be rules. Under channel topic, you actually want to put a little description. All right, save, close. Let's keep it going. Now you can click on the little plus here to create a channel. It'll ask you if it's text or voice, and then put your channel name here. We're gonna make the announcements channel. And we're pretty much done with the welcome, so I'm gonna collapse that. And we're just gonna populate the lobby. I think you get the point. Let's just do that. All right, and this is what we have so far. You can see under welcome, I have the roles, the announcements. For the lobby, I have chat, so general discussion, games. Here people can talk about games, post media about games, memes, of course, music, if people like to share music, movies and TV shows. And then media is usually for everything else. Post pictures of your food, your pets, anything. So under Cybernet, which is our bot channel, basically, I have the channel logs, so this is where my bot will post. I can make this private or not, doesn't really matter. And then I have commands. If some of my members need to communicate with a bot, whether to ask it a question or to get some information, some bots will give you points for participating in the server. So this is where they would ask, what level am I? Or show me the leaderboard. And then under the lounge category, we have watching, listening, gaming, co-working, AFK. So watching, if you are watching a movie, TV show, some YouTube content together, this is where you would do it. Listening, if you have a bot that plays music, or if you're listening to an audiobook and you would like to listen with other people. Gaming, self-explanatory. If you have a lot of gamers, you should consider adding an extra channel or two. And co-working, basically that means, hey, no talking in this channel. And finally, an AFK channel. This channel we will set up right now, actually. Let's go to our server settings. And if we go to engagement, and we scroll down, we should see inactive channel. And this is where we will set our AFK channel, right there. But also while we're here, system messages channel is where you would want to put that log channel that we created, logs channel. So when someone joins, it'll tell you right there. Remember to save. Also, while we're there, we want to take a look at roles. Now, roles are not that important in a private server. Usually it's people you trust that's going to be in there, but you can use roles to actually protect the server a little bit in case it gets leaked somehow and you have some bad actors join. So what I usually do is I create one big role that is going to become the default everyone role. I like giving roles names that have to do with the server name. I'm going to call this one attendee, and we're going to pick a color. I'm going to save changes, go back. Let's create another one. And this one will be for your mods. To be fair, in a private server, most likely you're going to have a single mod, maybe two, but that's not something to worry about too much either. Save changes, go to everyone. And this is what I mean by keeping your server secure. Now you're at everyone. You don't want people to view the channels. First of all, that solves a lot of the problems. You definitely don't want them to create an invite. You know, after setting it so that they can't view the channels, I don't know the extent of what they're capable of doing. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna save changes, and then I'm gonna right click on that role and click view server as role. So this is what someone with no roles basically will see. And that is absolutely nothing. So you don't have to fear anything, but that does mean that people who join your server will see absolutely nothing when they first come in. Now it's up to you to decide if you want to give them the roles manually. So you'll right click on their name when they join and then assign a role. Here's how you would do that. Just right click on the name because they will appear here, go to roles, and then just click attendee or mods or both, and boom, the channels will appear for them. So now let's go back to the roles, boom, server settings, roles, and let's make sure that the attendee role can do everything we want everyone to be able to do, like view channels by default, create expressions so they can add custom emotes, stickers, etc. I like to do that in private servers. We want them to be able to send messages in threads, create private threads, embed links, attach files, post photos and videos, add reactions, use emojis, use external emojis, use external stickers. Now, personally, I don't like the mention at everyone. Anything that says manage, you don't want that. Read message history, pretty important. Send text-to-speech messages can be annoying, but again, private server, you trust everyone not to abuse it. Send voice messages, create polls, voice channel permissions, connect, speak, video, soundboard, external sounds, voice activity, mute, deafen, and move members. That's a no-no. Use application commands, why not? Use activities, for sure. Create events, that's up to you. Manage events, not really. And then admin, well, not really, nope. All right, and then we have mods. But first of all, we want mods to be on top of attendees because the order actually matters. Whatever is on top has more permissions than whatever is underneath. So we're basically going to do the same thing for mods, but we're going to give them extra permissions because we want them to be able to manage certain things. But that's up to you. So I'm just going to skip forward. If you want to know more details about permissions, I have a whole video just dedicated to permissions. We basically turn on everything except manage server and administrator because we don't want them to be able to delete the server. But other than that, they have all permissions because if someone, let's say, gets their account compromised, you want your mods to be able to ban them to protect everyone else. There you go. Now, there are specific channels or specific categories where you want to override the roles. For example, you don't want your attendees to be able to type in the roles or announcement channel. So here you would go edit category, click on permissions. By default, you'll have everyone, and then you'll click on the plus to add the roles you want. In this case, attendee. By default, they'll be able to view the channel. Remember that. The only thing we need to make sure is that they can't write in there. So under send messages, click on that X. Create threads. I've had people do this accidentally. Turn that off also. Save changes. Remember that you can always test the roles by going to server settings, roles, right clicking on the role, and then view server as role. So right now on top, it'll see that I am viewing the server as the role, and the role is attendees. But now if I click on roles and I go down here, it'll tell me, hey, you do not have permission to send messages in this channel. So it's perfect. But if I want to go to the lobby to chat, boom, welcome to chat. I can type with no issues whatsoever. But that's the beauty of organizing your server. I can just set the permissions to the category and it will apply to the channels inside of it. Anyways, you pretty much have your server going on. It's totally functional right now. You could just, you know, start inviting people. But you can also make it look a little bit better. Now, there's multiple ways of doing it. Usually emojis are the way to go if you want color, but there's also like special symbols and all that stuff. That being said, if you want inspiration, I advise you to go to discordtemplates.me. You can see how they have their emojis set up and also their special characters. Again, for example, this looks decent, but there's so many emojis that are not showing up that it's, I don't know if it's worth it. What I do personally is edit my categories, go in front of the title, press Windows and period key on my keyboard, and then I'll find the symbols and then I'll just test them, see which ones are visible. You can see a lot of those just don't work. If you don't care about the emojis themselves and you're just looking for a specific color, you can just Google emoji by color, copy and paste, and you'll find a bunch of websites. From there, just click on them. It will copy it and go to edit category and place it. Bop, bop. There we go. And there we go. You end up with a small server that looks like this. Of course, there's a bunch of other stuff that you can do to make it more quote unquote aesthetic. I recommend you go watch another video on that subject. And that's pretty much it. I'm gonna turn this into a template. The link will be in the description. Just click on it and you'll have all of that. Modify it as you wish, invite your friends, give them the roles, you'll be done. If you would like to see any dedicated videos on Discord, let me know exactly what subject I should tackle next. Maybe one about Discord bots, maybe about Discord activities. Although last time I made a video about activities, it was my worst performing video ever. Also, make sure you check out my other videos about creating Discord servers. This one, for example, how to protect your Discord server and make it safer, how to make a personal Discord server for productivity, which is something that I still use to this day. And if you prefer the templates on those other videos, you can also go get those. After subscribing, make sure you set your notifications to all, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.